Welcome. I'm Jonathan Tepperman, Managing Editor of Foreign Affairs. We have with us a very special guest today. As well as being a friend of the magazine, Dr. Philip Zelikow was Executive Director of the 9/11 Commission. He's just come out with a new update of the Commission report, part of which is excerpted on our site, foreignaffairs.com. And I can think of no one better to talk about the ways in which the country has responded to the attacks in the last 10 years and just as importantly, the way in which it hasn't. So let me start there. Using your report as a yardstick, tell us how well the country has responded in terms of putting in place new measures to protect itself in the years since.
Sure, the country responded massively in every direction it could think of, enormous expenditure of resources. The Commission's recommendations channeled and directed some of that, prompted some structural improvements that have turned out to be important. The lead of which I'd single out is the creation of the National Counterterrorism Center, or NCTC, that has bridged the foreign domestic divide and brought federal and local governments together and has basically been a useful and important innovation. There are some other things that we recommended at the procedural level that have been important. But the bottom line is there's a massive response, a lot of resources thrown at the problem over the years, some things we recommended, a lot of things people were doing anyway. And the bottom line is that yes, that's had an effect. Country is safer than it was. Things we've done overseas have degraded the enemy terrorist capability, culminating in the killing of bin Laden himself, and the continuing hunting of senior al-Qaeda leaders in other countries. But also America is now a safer place than it was. Terrorists find it much more difficult to travel here. The 9/11 hijackers actually staged and trained over a period of months inside the United States, confident that America was safe for them. That's no longer the case. Cumulatively, that's helped. We still have to be vigilant, but the bottom line is that the outpouring of effort that you saw and that our commission helped direct has had a positive effect.
Now, in your book and in your article for Foreign Affairs Online, you talk about something called the paradox of adjustment. Can you explain that?
Sure. Before 9/11, we had a paradox of prevention, which is that it's very hard to mobilize people at the time you can prevent a threat before the threat's obvious to everyone. And then, therefore, you haven't prevented it anymore. The paradox of adjustment is now you've mobilized everyone on the threat. And now it's hard to mobilize them on anything else because you've created such a tremendous momentum in the society about this. Organizations built up, a lot of people working on it, that it's now very difficult to change direction because the president talks about, well, the risk is less. That's politically risky for him to say because an attack could happen the next day. You don't want to dull the edge of alertness or invite complacency. So ironically, it's very hard to talk about a reduced risk because it feels too risky to do it. Mm-hmm. That's the paradox of adjustment. That's the phase we're in now. We need to find a way of dialing this down some and adjusting to this for the long haul, but without saying the threat's gone away. And that's just a very hard mode for a complex society like ours.
Sure. Now, another thing you write about in your piece that I want to ask you about is civil liberties. How well do you feel the country has struck the balance between these contradictory impulses in the last 2 years? On the one hand, to do everything possible to keep the country safe, and the other hand, to both avoid overextending internationally and becoming excessively repressive at home.
Yeah, I think actually we've done pretty well on civil liberties. They're very controversial. I thought we made some significant mistakes on interrogation practices. There was a backlash to those mistakes. I was actually part of that backlash. I think that was actually put on a much better track by around 2006 mm-hmm. and has remained on a healthier track since then in the area of interrogations. In civil liberties for Americans, I think from the start, the Bush administration scared a lot of people because it asserted things in a way that frankly scared a lot of people. But in practice, the reactions of the courts and even people inside the administration tempered a lot of this, like those threatened resignations in 2004. So that for some years now, I think we've been striking a pretty healthy balance. Because unfortunately, the greatest danger to civil liberties would be another catastrophic terrorist attack. So you shouldn't see civil liberties and security as a dilemma. Security is the way you get the protection of civil liberties. So you have to have an adequate level of security and then strike the balance as to how you get there. And I I think we're in a pretty good place on that at the moment.
Dr. Zelikow, I have about 100 more questions that I could ask you, but that's all we have time for. Thank you very much for speaking to us.
Thank you.